Hello, my name is Olinda Isabella. I'm an assistant professor in the Photovoltaics Materials and Devices Group at TU Delft. Welcome to the third course in our MicroMaster series, Solar Energy Engineering. This third course is called the Photovoltaic Systems. And in this course, you will learn about all the aspects involved in the design of a variety of photovoltaic systems. This course can be followed as a standalone course. If you are interested in the physics, engineering, and the processing of solar cells, I advise you to follow the PV1X photovoltaic energy conversion or PV2X photovoltaic technologies courses. Let me first introduce the lecturers of this course. I have already introduced myself, Olindo Isabella, and I will be accompanied by Dr. Ravi Vasudevan. Ravi and I work in the Photovoltaic Materials and Devices Group at Delft University of Technology. Our group has expertise in teaching and research in all aspects of photovoltaics, from fundamentals to device fabrication and full system design. The course Photovoltaic Systems is split into five parts. The first part will serve as a short introduction. In the second part, which takes place in week two, we discuss all the issues involved with the location of a PV system. The third part, which consists of 2 weeks, we look into the PV module. In part 4, which takes another 2 weeks, we consider all the necessary balance of system components required to make a PV system. Finally, in part 5, we will apply the knowledge of all preceding weeks to design and integrate a PV system. Let's go through all of these 5 sections in a bit more detail. The first week is a short introduction into PV systems design. This week contains only a few videos, and this gives you the time to get familiar with the system design assignments, which we shall discuss later. In week 2, we discuss the location issues. First, we will discuss the solar irradiance and the different components of irradiance on Earth. You will learn to define the position of the sun in the sky, and we will use that to calculate the optimal tilt angle and orientation for solar modules for any position on Earth. At the end of week 2, we will discuss landscape survey, where you will learn to predict the influence of surrounding area on the annual PV system performance. Finally, you will be introduced to some advanced irradiance modeling techniques. In week 3 and 4 of the course, we will discuss the PV modules. In the PV1X and the PV2X, we discuss the operation principles of solar cells and many different PV technologies. In this section, you will learn how multiple solar cells are used to make a PV module. We will look at the different interconnection techniques and at the design concepts of the metal contacts of the modules. You will learn all about the operation of PV modules, what happens to the current and voltage of a module when a single cell is shaded. For example, we shall answer questions like why do we include diodes in the module and how many diodes should be included. We will also look into the performance of a PV module under increased temperature and irradiance. Finally, we will discuss how temperature, partial shading, and moisture affect the reliability of PV modules and how this is tested. Solar modules alone are not enough to make a PV system, of course. In part 4 of the course, we will look at all the balance of system components required to design a PV system. We will discuss in detail the operation of DC to DC converters, DC to AC inverters, energy storage units like batteries, charge controllers, and even the cables and the mounting frames. You will also learn about maximum power point tracking logic that is usually contained in one of the balance of system components. In the final part of the course, you will learn all the skills required to design a PV system. PV system design often starts with an analysis of the load that needs to be powered. Load analysis is therefore important to determine the size of your PV system. We will provide you with the skills to design a PV system of any size and type, ranging from rural, standalone, and local grid systems to grid-connected and building-integrated systems, all the way up to complete power plants. The final section of this course will focus on the integration of PV systems. You will learn about the issues related to integrating PV systems in the existing power grid. And finally, some aspects of PV systems from a financial point of view will be discussed. We recommend following this course along with our textbook, Solar Energy, Physics and Engineering of Photovoltaic Conversion Technologies and Systems. This textbook is available as a free ebook for any e-reader on Amazon. Hard copies are also available for purchase at Amazon.com as well as other retailers. Now, the assessment. Following most of the video lectures, you will find exercises to apply your new gained knowledge. These exercises are meant to test and improve your understanding of the concepts discussed in the videos. So try the exercises and don't be afraid to make a mistake. All the weekly exercises combined count for 10% towards your final grade. New in this course are the system design assignments. In these assignments, you will learn to apply the theoretical knowledge to design an optimal PV system. In this course, we use a web-based version of MATLAB to run and assess the system design assignments. In the Getting Started week, you will find some MATLAB tutorials to help you get started. However, please note that the design assignments are about transferring skills, not MATLAB code. When designing your own PV system, you can use whatever computational software you prefer. Each week we'll have one system design assignment, which in total counts for 10% towards your final grade. Finally, the proctored exam is only available to ID verified students and counts for 80% towards your final grade. You can qualify for the PV3X verified certificate by achieving a minimal final score of 65%. Besides the regular content, PV3X also features a live webinar in which you can interact live with the course team. The webinar generally includes a behind-the-scenes tour at the TU Delft, an interview with a titan of industry, and an interactive discussion in which the course team treats the issues introduced by the students. You can then submit your solar energy-related questions a couple of weeks in advance. Look for more information in the webinar tab of the Getting Started week. The ID-verified students will have access to the exciting challenges. The challenges are topical issues where the course teams interact with the ID-verified students. Each challenge will receive a feedback video. You can find the challenges in the MicroMasters community tab at the end of each week. All the information provided in this video can be found in the course syllabus. On behalf of the Photovoltaic Materials and Devices team here at Delft University of Technology, I'm very excited to provide this course for you. I hope you are ready to dive right into all different aspects involved in the design of a PV system.